The previous two videos, we have studied the basic theory of three-port network. Now, in this video, we are going to study the basic theory of four-port network. Actually, four-port network is the basic configuration for directional coupler. This is an example for a general directional coupler. Here is the input port, here is the output port. Here the coupled forward port, here the coupled backward port. So we can represent such direction coupler as a four port network, port 1, port 2, port 3, and port 4. From port 1 is the input, port 2 is the through, port 3 is the coupled signal from the forward direction, and port 4 is the coupled from the reflected. So it is isolated with respect to the input. So it is assumed that there is no power going directly from port 1 to port 4, and there is no power going directly from port 2 to port 3. We will see this property now. For a matched four-port network, the general scattering matrix, if we are talking about matched and reciprocal network, so the scattering matrix of a reciprocal four-port network matched at all ports is along the diagonal, all the S parameters, SII is 0. So S11, S22, S33, S44 should be 0. And because it is reciprocal, S12 equals S21, S13 equals S31, S23 equals S32, and S24 equals, this should be S24 equals S42 and S34 equals S43. So this is a general scattering matrix for a four-port network directional coupler, matched directional coupler, matched and reciprocal. Alright. To be lossless, we have to satisfy two conditions. The first condition is that the summation of the magnitude square of any row or any column should be unique. This means that the summation S11 square, S12 squared plus S13 squared plus S14 squared should be unique. The summation S12 squared, S23 squared, S24 squared is unique, and so on. And the other condition is the multiplication of the conjugate of any row by another row should be zero. So the conjugate of first row multiplied by the second row should be zero. The conjugate of the first row with the third row should be zero. The conjugate of the first row with the fourth row should be zero, and so on. Let us first start with the condition of the multiplication of the conjugate of different rows. So starting from the row S13, okay, we are going to take the conjugate of column S13, S23, S14, S24. So the conjugate of the first column multiplied by the second column would be, the first term is 0, the second term is 0, S13 conjugate multiplied by S23, S14 conjugate multiplied by S24 equals 0. So the first condition is S13 conjugate multiplied by S23 plus S14 conjugate multiplied by S24 equals 0. This conjugate multiplied by this, and this conjugate multiplied by this equals 0, and the remaining two terms are 0. The second one is S14 conjugate multiplied by S13, S14 conjugate. So this one multiplied by S13 plus S24 conjugate multiplied by S23 plus 0 plus 0. So S14 conjugate multiplied by S13 plus S24 conjugate multiplied by S23. The last column conjugate multiplied by the third column equals 0. Alright. Another two columns, S2, S1, to conjugate multiply by is to 3. So we are talking about the first column and the third column. S12 conjugate multiplied by S23 plus S14 conjugate multiplied by S34 equals 0. And the remaining two terms are already 0. So the conjugate of the first column multiplied by the third column is S12 conjugate multiplied by S23 plus S14 conjugate multiplied by S34 equals 0. Finally, this S14 and this S12. So the last column multiplied by the second column. S14 conjugate multiplied by S12 plus 0 plus S34 conjugate multiplied by S23 plus 0. So the last column conjugate multiplied by the second column will introduce this fourth equation. S14 conjugate multiplied by S12 plus S34 conjugate multiplied by S23 equals 0. So these are the conditions for conjugate column multiplied by another column equals 0. We have four conditions. If we are going to try any other column combination, we will obtain some repeating of these four equations. So these are the basic four equations in this case. Now let us study the first two equations. Here we have S13 conjugate multiplied by S23 plus S14 conjugate multiplied by S24. The second equation is S14 conjugate multiplied by S13 and plus S24 conjugate multiplied by S23. If we multiply the first equation by S23 conjugate, here we are going to multiply this by S13 conjugate. The second equation we are going to multiply by S13 conjugate. So it would be S14 conjugate multiplied by S13 multiplied by S13 conjugate. This means S13 squared. The second term is would be S24 conjugate multiplied by S23 multiplied by S13 conjugate. Alright? And we are going to multiply the first equation by S24 conjugate. So this would be S13 conjugate, S23, S24 conjugate. And here S14 conjugate, S24 multiplied by S24 conjugate, S24 multiplied by S24 conjugate, it would be S24 squared. Now we are going to subtract this equation after multiplying by S24 conjugate from this equation after multiplying by S13 conjugate. So the remaining two terms would be S14 conjugate multiplied by S13 squared minus S14 conjugate multiplied by S24 squared. The remaining two terms here we will have S13 conjugate, S23, S24 conjugate, and here we have S24 conjugate, S23, S13 conjugate. So this term will be eliminated with this term. This once again, I am going to multiply the first equation by S24 conjugate and multiply the second equation by S13 conjugate. Then I'll take the first equation after multiplication minus the second equation after multiplication. This term will be eliminated with this term, and the remaining would be S14 conjugate multiplied by S13 square minus S24 square. And because this equals 0 and this equals 0, so this minus this would be 0. And because S14 conjugate multiplied by S13 minus S24 equals 0, this can be obtained either by S13 equals S24 or it can be obtained by S14 equals 0. Actually, we are going to take the option that S14 equals 0. In a similar way, the other two equations here. Here we have S12 conjugate S23 plus S14 conjugate S34. We are going to multiply this equation by S12. And the second equation is S14 conjugate S12 plus S34 conjugate S23. We are going to multiply this equation by S34. So, after multiplying this by S34 and multiplying this by S12, we can find that this term would be exactly this term. So, by subtracting these two equations after this multiplication process, we can obtain that S23 multiplied by S1 conjugate multiplied by S212 is S12 squared. Minus S23 multiplied by S34 conjugate multiplied by S34, which is S34 squared. So we have S23 multiplied by S12 squared minus S34 squared equals 0. If this equation is 0, this means that either S12 equals S34 or S23 is 0. We are going to choose that the option S23 is 0. So from these two equations, we can obtain that for the case of lossless four-port network, a good choice is that S14 equals S23 equals 0. S14 equals S23 equals 0. This means that the tilted diagonal, this diagonal in the tilt, is also 0. So we have the original diagonal is 0 and the tilted diagonal is also 0. The remaining part is S12, S13, S24, S34. Alright? So, in this case, if you are going to assume that S14 and S23 are 0, and we are taking the magnitude of each row, so the first row, it would be S12 squared plus S13 squared plus 0. So, S12 squared plus S13 squared equals 1. The magnitude of the second column, it would be S12 squared plus S24 squared, because S23 is 0. So S12 squared plus S24 is unity. The third one is S13 squared plus S34 squared is unity. Finally, S24 squared plus S34 squared is unity. So these are the equations of the magnitude squared of each row. Right. From these two equations, we find that S12 squared plus S13 squared equals 1, and S12 squared plus S24 squared equal 1. This means that the magnitude of S13 should equal the magnitude of S24. S13 as a magnitude equals S24. And from these two equations, we have here S12 squared plus S24 squared, and here S24 squared plus S34 squared equals unity. So both of them has S24. This means that S12 as a magnitude must equal the magnitude of S34. Now, from this discussion, we obtain that S14 should equal S23 equals 0. And the magnitude of S13 should equal the magnitude of S24. And the magnitude of S12 should equal the magnitude of S34. Let us combine these three conditions together to see the S parameters of the four-port directional coupler. These are the three conditions. S14 equals S23 equals 0. This means that if the bar is going from port 1, there is no bar is going to port 4. This means that port 4 would be isolated from the input 1. In a similar way, if the bar is going from port 2, there is no bar is going to port 3. So port 3 is isolated from port 2. Now, the port from bar 1 is going to port 3 as S13. It equals the bar is going from port 2 to port 4. So we are going to assume that S13 equals S24 such that S13 has a magnitude of beta, for example, and phase equals theta, and S24 has the same magnitude, and in general has another phase, assuming that it is phi. In a similar way, the third condition is S12, the bar going from port 1 to port 2, which is the throw, equals the bar going from port 3 to port 4. So S12 equals S34 equals alpha. Okay, now returning back here, the tilted diagonal is 0. Here the magnitude is beta, which is, sorry, the magnitude is alpha, S12, and the magnitude here is beta. So the magnitude alpha squared plus beta squared must equal unity, because S12 squared as a magnitude plus S13 squared as a magnitude equal unity. The magnitude of S12 is alpha, and the magnitude of S13 is beta, so alpha squared plus beta squared must be unique. The magnitude of alpha and beta are not independent, they are related as alpha squared plus beta squared equal unique. On the other hand, if we are talking about the multiplication of the second column with the third column, so S12 conjugate multiplied by S13 plus S24 conjugate multiplied by S34 should be 0. Once again, S12 is alpha, S13 is beta, e to the power g theta. So this alpha multiplied alpha beta multiplied by or alpha beta with a phase theta. Okay. Here S12 is conjugate, and S12 is assumed to be have an angle 0. So there is nothing here. So alpha multiplied by beta with an angle theta. This is the first term. The second term is S24 conjugate. S24 conjugate is beta to the power e to the power minus j phi, because this is conjugate. We are going to replace any j by minus j. This means that the angle here is minus phi, not phi. So beta with an angle minus phi multiplied by alpha. So this is alpha beta with an angle minus phi. This should equal 0. To this be 0, we can take alpha beta as a magnitude. So we have alpha beta as a magnitude multiplied by 1 plus e to the power j theta multiplied plus e to the power minus j phi equals 0. We can take e to the power j theta as a common, so we have 1 plus e to the power minus j phi plus theta, and this should equal 0. To be 0, this means that the value of theta plus phi should be pi, or pi plus 2 pi, or pi minus 2 pi, or in general case, pi plus or minus 2 n pi. So the relation between the angle theta and the angle phi is that theta plus y equals 5 plus or minus multiple number of 2 pi. So we have a relation between alpha and beta, and we have a relation between theta and phi. Alpha squared plus beta squared equal 1, and theta plus phi equals pi plus multiple of 2 pi. This actually the isoparameters of a general four-port directional coupler. We have equal magnitude for S1 to S3-4, which is the throw. The throw is alpha, and the coupling is beta. From 1 to 3, the magnitude is beta. The phase from 1 to 3 is theta. The phase from 2 to 4 is phi. The relation between the angle from 1 to 3 and the angle from 2 to 4 is theta plus phi equals 1. Okay, all right.